steganography is a way to hide secret information inside ordinary-looking files, like pictures or music. It's a bit like hiding a message in plain sight where no one expects to find it. You can hide things like passwords, codes, or IP addresses in these files. This makes it harder for people to find and access the hidden information. Steganography isn't the same as cryptography, which is about scrambling information to make it unreadable. But sometimes, people use both methods together for extra security. There are different ways to use steganography. Here, we'll talk about five types. Text steganography. This type hides a message inside a piece of text. One way to do this is by swapping letters around. After swapping letters, see, the hidden message becomes clear after swapping the letters back. It's a simple example, but steganography can be much more complex and creative. Image steganography is one of the most amazing types. It's about hiding secret messages or data inside digital images. There are different methods to do this, like least significant bit technique. This method hides data in the least significant bit of each pixel in an image. Masking and filtering. Here, you manipulate the image's color values to hide the data. Coding and cosine transformation. This technique uses mathematical transformations to embed the data in the image. Check out these two images. Can you spot any difference between them? Probably not, right? But look at the file sizes. The image on the right is bigger because it's hiding a 260-word text inside it. Audio steganography is all about hiding secret messages in audio files. One popular method is called black masking. This is where a hidden message is embedded in the audio and can only be heard when the audio is played backward. For instance, the rapper Eminem used black masking in his song, Stimulate, released in 2002. Network steganography is less common but intriguing. It involves hiding messages in network traffic. These hidden messages can be found in the data packet's payload or headers when examined by the receiver. Let's dive into image steganography with an example using StegEyed. StegEyed is a free tool for image steganography that uses the least significant bit technique. Here's how it works. Images are made of pixels, which are made of bits. The bit depth tells us how many colors are in an image. A higher bit depth means more colors. LSB changes the last bit of each byte, or pixel, in the image to hide data. This alters the image slightly, but it's usually not noticeable. The higher the bit depth and resolution, the more data you can hide. Ready for a little demonstration? Here's what you'll need. A Linux operating system, an internet connection, an image, and a text file. To start, you'll need to install StegEyed. Open your terminal and type in the following command. Sudo apt install StegEyed. After installation, you can type StegEyed. Help to see a list of commands and options available. Now, gather an image and a text file in one directory. For this example, let's use information.txt and image.png. Make sure you have some text in the text file that you want to hide in the image. Navigate to your directory using the terminal. Now, run the following command to embed the text file into the image. Here's what each part means. StegEyed is the tool we're using. Embed. Tell StegEyed to embed data. EF specifies the file you want to hide. CF specifies the image file you want to use as a cover. SF creates a new image with the embedded data. And V gives detailed information about the process. You'll be prompted to enter a password for added security. If you don't want to set a password, just press enter twice. And there you have it. You've successfully hidden text inside an image using StegEyed. Cool, right? Let's examine the new image we created. At first glance, they look identical, right? To be sure, you can use a tool like diffchecker.com to compare them in detail. Since the Stego image has hidden data, it's slightly larger than the original. You can extract this data using the following command. Here's what each part means. SF is the Stego image containing the hidden data, and XF is the file where the extracted data will be saved. After running this command, you should see something like this. If you see the extracted text, you've successfully hidden and retrieved text from an image. You can even hide entire books using this method. It's great for protecting secrets. Always be responsible with what you learn, and use it for good reasons. Stay safe online.